Hi, good morning, my dear students. Once again, welcome back to the second episode of our geography part. In first episode, we just completed the introduction of the atmosphere. Okay, and we know that atmosphere is a blanket of air surrounded by the earth. Okay, and another important thing, you know, our earth is also known as blue planet, watery planet, living planet, or unique planet. Okay, different names are there for our earth. Our earth is unique in the solar system. Okay, and earth is the third planet in the solar system. You know, the first one is Mercury, second one is Venus, third is earth. Mercury, Venus, earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune, these are the eight planets in the solar system. And our earth is neither very far away nor very close to the sun. Because of this optimum distance, our earth has some unique features or specialities compared to other planets. Okay, when we go to when we study about Mercury and Venus, you know, the temperature is very very high. And when we go to Neptune, the temperature is very very severe cold. Okay, so both this extreme hot and extreme cold, we can't survive. And because of those reasons, our earth has an optimum distance as well as optimum comfortable condition on the earth for maintaining or surviving the life on the earth. And we can see only life is only found in our earth as per the researches conducted by the scientists. Okay, and moreover, the presence of water and atmosphere makes the life more comfortable in the earth. Okay, and we can't see this atmosphere and water any other planets or any other satellites. Okay, so we can be proud of our earth, and it is our duty to protect our earth from different types of pollution and damage. Okay, we should not destroy our earth because our earth is our mother. Okay, or we call it as Mother Bhumi. Okay, so it is our responsibility to respect and treat well our living planet earth. Okay, so my dear students, let us go to the chapter. You know, in previous classes we studied that our atmosphere comprises of many gases. Mainly two gases are there, that is nitrogen. It covers around 78% of the atmosphere. 78% of atmosphere is comprised by nitrogen, that is very important for the growth of plants and trees. Okay, especially cereals, cereal plants requires nitrogen for making their seeds as well as their grains. Okay, and remaining 21% is oxygen, and this oxygen makes our life more comfortable because we, the living beings, human beings and animals, are also taking oxygen, and we are breathing out carbon dioxide. And you know, the plants and trees are breathing in carbon dioxide and they are breathing out oxygen. So we are depending each other. Mutual dependence is there between human beings, living beings, animals, and animals and human beings with the plants and trees. Okay, plants and trees also depends us. So there is a mutual relationship we can see among plants and trees and other living beings. Okay, so this maintains the balance of our earth. Okay, the life on the earth, mutual. So it is our duty to not to destroy plants and trees. If we are destroying the plants and trees, what we are actually doing, we are cutting the branch where we are sitting. Okay, we are cutting the branch of a tree. This we can compare with a situation just like if a person who is cutting the branch where he is sitting, he will fell down, definitely. Okay, like that, if we are cutting the trees or plants and trees, we are destroying, actually we are just like killing ourselves. So if we want to grow well, if we want to have a better life, we should allow the plants and trees to grow, and moreover we want to plant more trees and plants over the earth. Okay, so that is our responsibility. Okay, and remaining 1%, when we add 78 and 21, we will be getting 99, and remaining 1% comprises of carbon dioxide, argon, carbon monoxide, like that, minute gases. Okay, even though this carbon monoxide is also in minute level, nowadays the percentage of carbon monoxide in the atmosphere is increasing because of the presence of, because of the uses of motor vehicles, including car, bike, scooter, okay, and even, you know, trains are also producing outward smogs. Okay, nowadays many trains are running by using electricity, so the pollution is a little bit decreased, but again then also we can see some type of trains are also running with the fuel of coal, so the smoke is also polluting the atmosphere. Okay, so the carbon monoxide is increasing day by day, and this is causing many lung diseases like asthma and more skin diseases, allergy. Okay, many problems are there because of the carbon monoxide. Okay, now let us come back again to the earth. You know, atmosphere is the layer of blanket of air. It is a layer of air, or we can say blanket of air, and this air contains, I told, nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, like that, many gases are there. Okay, when we go outside, when we go 160 meters up from the surface of the earth, 1 degree Celsius of temperature will decrease. Okay, that is when we go 1 kilometer in another ways, in another way I can explain you like that. If we go in a height of 1 kilometer from the surface of the earth, around approximately 4.6 degrees Celsius is decreasing. Okay, here on, nearby the surface of the earth, the pressure is very high because heavy gases are present on the surface of the earth. Okay, so because of this pressure by the air or the atmosphere, we have so many problems. We have many gravitational problems are there. Whereas when we go to the another planet, source moon, you know, the gravitational force of the moon is very less, and moreover there is no atmosphere. Okay, there is no pressure. If we are walking there, we will feel we are just like running. Okay, so earth. Okay, earth has you know, atmosphere we can divide into 5 different layers according to the density of the air. Okay, according to the density of the air and certain features, we can divide the atmosphere into 5 categories. Okay, yesterday we already studied these things. Once again I shall introduce you about these things. The first layer we call it as troposphere. Okay, troposphere, its height is from the equator, its height is 8 kilometers, and from the polar region it is 18 kilometers. Okay, so that is the area of or range of troposphere. Okay, and above troposphere we can see stratosphere. Its height is, its ranges from 18 kilometers to 50 kilometers. Okay, and many jet planes are also moving through this stratosphere, and there is no any hindrance of any clouds. Okay, so smoothly the planes can travel. And whereas in troposphere we can see many mountains, clouds are also we can see, and rainfall, that is precipitation, is mainly occurring in the tropospheric layer. Okay, and coming to the third one, that is mesosphere. The word meso means middle, so mesosphere means middle sphere in between troposphere and stratosphere. and ionosphere and exosphere. So we can see this is third one. Okay, third in between, third layer in between the fifth layer. Okay, 1 and 2 is troposphere and stratosphere. 4 and 5 is ionosphere and exosphere. So the third one is the middle. So we call it as mesosphere. Okay, and mesosphere, the height of mesosphere is 50 kilometers to 80 kilometers. Okay, and after mesosphere we can see ionosphere, and it has active radio waves. It reflects many radio waves. Okay, many whatever sounds we are producing in the earth is, according to scientists, whatever sounds we are producing from the earth, it is going upside and it is being recorded in the ionosphere. Okay, and some scientists are telling even we can reproduce the sounds of our ancient people. Some studies are also going on behind that, and because of this ionosphere we are able to communicate through, we are able to use many telecommunications like television, radio, mobile phone, internet services. Okay, all these things are possible because of ionosphere. Okay, and you know, nowadays we are using online classes, we are studying the things through online classes due to COVID-19, the most pandemic disastrous disease in the world. Okay, and this, now you can understand, you can understand the importance of this ionosphere. Without ionosphere this learning will not be happen. Okay, so this is one of the most blessings of the nature or the God. Okay, whatever may be, we are blessed with the ionosphere. Okay, can you imagine a life without television, mobile phone, radio, internet? Never. Nowadays this modern period we are living with these devices, and these devices became one of the organs of our body, like mobile phone. Okay, wherever we are going we are carrying mobile phone. Our life is totally dependent upon our mobile phone. Okay, with the mobile phone. So that is the importance of ionosphere. Okay, this ionosphere, we can see many satellites are launched there, and they are capturing the, they are the mediator between our television news channels or bureaus. Okay, from where the news is producing, and it is being sent to the satellite, and from the satellite it is sending to, if it is mobile phone, take the case of mobile phones. If suppose I am calling to a person in America, what will happen? I am calling and my message is going to the nearby tower, and from the tower it is going to the satellite, and again from the satellite it is going to, that wave is going to the, transferred to the tower of America, and from that tower that messages are going to the mobile phone in the America. Okay, so this is how the communication is possible. That is the importance of ionosphere. Okay, it reflects radio waves. And the final is exosphere. Its length is more than 400 kilometers approximately. It may go to 1000 kilometers. Okay, so these are the different types of, 5 types of atmosphere on our earth. Okay, so I hope you understood this segment, and please read the chapter. Till then, take care. Have a nice day. Thank you.